Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to create custom keyboard shortcuts on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to its Patreon supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So it's been a while since I've talked about custom keyboard shortcuts. On a Mac, you can assign a custom keyboard shortcut to any menu item in any application. You can even change the default shortcuts used by an app. So you can create a keyboard shortcut for any item you find in a menu. The thing you need to do is note the exact name for the menu item. So for instance, here in Safari in Bookmarks, there's a menu item called Show Bookmarks. You have to look at the name and get it right exactly. Show space bookmarks. Note it doesn't matter what the name of the menu is, in this case bookmarks. You don't have to worry about that. Just the name of the item itself. Most menu items already have a keyboard shortcut assigned to them. But for ones that don't, like Show Bookmarks here in Safari, you can assign your own. To do this, go to System Preferences and then go to Keyboard. Then click on Shortcuts at the top. Here you'll see a list of system keyboard shortcuts. What you want to do is go down to the last item, App Shortcuts. This will list all of your custom keyboard shortcuts. To create one, hit the plus button here. Then choose which application the menu item appears in. In this case, it's Safari. So we'll choose Safari. And then we'll type the exact name of the menu item. Now when I say you have to type the menu name exactly, I mean exactly. You have to even get the case of each letter exactly right. Then click in this field here and then type your keyboard shortcut. A keyboard shortcut should use a combination of modifier keys and then a regular key in your keyboard. The modifier keys are Command, Option, Control, and Shift. So for instance, we can do Command, Option, Control, and then the B key to represent this keyboard shortcut. You'll see symbols representing each one of those modifier keys here in the field. Then click Add. Now you'll see it appear here. If you ever want to edit it, you can click on the shortcut field there to change the keyboard shortcut. You can also click on the name here if you've typed it wrong to make a correction. Now if we go back to Safari and we look in the Bookmarks menu, we can see Show Bookmarks has that shortcut assigned. This is the first thing you want to do. You want to check to make sure you entered the menu name correctly. If you don't see this here, there's no point even trying the keyboard shortcut because you've made a mistake. So once you see it here, you can give it a try. So I'm going to try it here and you can see it shows bookmarks here on the left. Now a few things to note. The first is if a menu item is disabled, it's grayed out, then it won't work whether you choose it in the menu or use the keyboard shortcut. It's simply not active now. So the menu item action has to be a valid action for whatever it is you're doing. Second, whenever you've got these three dots here, you can use three periods or Option and the semicolon to represent that. Either one will work in System Preferences to match the menu item. Another thing to note is that sometimes menu items change names. For instance, notice Show Bookmarks isn't there anymore. It's now Hide Bookmarks, because bookmarks are shown. And there's no keyboard shortcut for Hide Bookmarks. But we can add a keyboard shortcut for this very easily. I'll just add one here in Safari and I'll use exactly the same keyboard shortcut. So you see them both there. So now you can toggle that back and forth because both Hide Bookmarks and Show Bookmarks have the same keyboard shortcut. So I can just go back and forth with those. Now I can also use the same method to change keyboard shortcuts. So here I am in Mail and under Message, Reply All is Shift Command R. Let's say I want to change that. So I can go to System Preferences here. I can add a new one. This time I'm going to set the app to Mail. And then I'm going to type the exact name for the menu item. Then I'm going to set the keyboard shortcut to Shift Option Command R and add it. Now if I go back into Mail and I look here, you can see that Reply All now has a different keyboard shortcut. If you ever want to remove one you've added, you can simply select it and then hit the minus button. Now sometimes you want to use a keyboard shortcut that works across all apps. Here in Safari, if I want to share a page using AirDrop, I can go to File, Share, AirDrop, and there's no keyboard shortcut for that. Other apps have the exact same menu item. Here I am in Notes, and if I go to File, Share, there's AirDrop there as well. So let's create a keyboard shortcut that will work in all apps. So here in System Preferences, I can add the shortcut. For application, I'll go all the way to the top of the list and just say All Applications. Then I'll add the name of the menu item exactly and do a keyboard shortcut. So I'll do Command Option Control Shift A and I'll hit Add. Now if I go into Safari here under File Share, I could see that's the shortcut for sharing with AirDrop. And if I'm in Notes, it's the same exact shortcut. So it's universal across all the apps that have that menu item. This works in Mac apps and third-party apps, anything that uses the Mac menu bar. Now the reason this exists is because each Mac user is a little different. There may be menu items that you use all the time that other people never use. So this gives you the ability to assign custom keyboard shortcuts to the things that matter the most to you. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.